It may not look like it, but our latest short, OZYMANDIAS, was produced with Unreal and a new software called EbSynth. In short, Unreal is used to quickly create the scene, and EbSynth is used to apply the final look to each shot by painting over a minimal amount of frames. In this case, only one frame was painted for each shot. This video will break down the creation process behind OZYMANDIAS, and hopefully give you some ideas of how you can use Unreal and EbSynth in your work. This type of workflow is very accessible as it can ingest assets of any quality. What you need is time and creativity. Now, what is the point of EbSynth? Well, one of the main issues with real-time productions is that, even though everything is potentially much faster, 3D in general remains expensive and time-consuming. The amount of work required to go from a rough scene to the final edit is tremendous, especially with photorealistic rendering. What is extremely fast, however, is achieving a rough previs, though it will have this video game look that makes it unsuitable for distribution. EbSynth is a magical tool that takes your previs scene and gives it a unique aesthetic. It works with texture synthesis, though it may look like style transfer from the outside. The possibilities are endless, and you can use pretty much any asset with no need for optimization or improvements. The idea of the short stemmed from a reading by Brian Cranston of OZYMANDIAS, a poem written by Percy Shelley, which I stumbled upon as I was researching English poetry. A few adaptations had already been done, but I wondered if I could do something that would be a little different using Unreal. The scene was quickly put together using Sequencer. I tried to go for a variety of shots, which would test different aspects of working with EbSynth. Occlusions, dolly zoom, animations, or lens distortion. The first goal of the scene is to be somewhat historically accurate, using 3D scans of Egyptian artifacts related to OZYMANDIAS, or as we call him, Ramses II. It was interesting to see how the poem diverges from reality. Most depictions of Ramses aren't frightening or contemptuous at all. In fact, the pharaoh is mostly depicted as a benevolent figure. I did find this head, however, which could fit the severe aspect described by Shelley. The legs were taken from an unrelated statue from Close Sovereign, and the different architectural elements were taken from megascans, along with a few rocky cliffs. The scene is completed with an animal pack and a desert landscape taken from the Unreal Marketplace. Without EbSynth, I wouldn't be able to use most of these assets, megascans aside, without reworking them considerably. 3D scans taken from Sketchfab in particular are not production ready at all. The textures are lacking, the mesh is messy, the UV is problematic, the resolution is too low for close-ups. Though hey, they're kindly provided for free and are perfect for EbSynth. Using the Sketchfab add-on, you can directly open them in Blender, make a few tweaks, and send them over to Unreal using the Send to Unreal Blender add-on. A few clicks and voila, I have my scene. If it weren't for EbSynth, I would probably have to do a lot of work to ensure that I can use these assets. In the case of photorealistic rendering, I would be looking at hours or days of work depending on what I want to achieve. Using this workflow, you can probably use anything that you can get your hands on, and so any marketplace becomes Alibaba's cave. Once your first shot is ready, you can export the result using the recently updated Movie Render Cube. To achieve better results, you want to export the different elements of the scene separately. In my case, I used layers in Unreal to group up certain elements so long as they do not occlude each other. Try to think of the different layers as different planes parallel to the camera lens. You can then export these layers one after the other as image sequences. Depending on the way you will stylize the image, you can also export the shadows in the scene. There are multiple ways to do that, for example by disabling the option to render in main pass in the details panel. Keep in mind that the more you split up the different elements, the more control you may have over your results, but EbSynth can achieve pretty solid details even when dealing with complex patterns, so you can get away with isolating just a few characters and using the rest of the scene as it is. EbSynth is currently in beta phase and free to use for an undetermined period of time. You can head over to Secret Weapon's website to download the latest version. The team has also put out a number of quick tutorials to get you started. Now that the shots have been exported in PNG format, it's time to process them with EbSynth. Organization is key here, because you will potentially end up with a large number of files depending on the complexity of the scene. To avoid this, I tried to keep it simple when creating the environments and camera shots for OZYMANDIAS, but it can deal with scenes which are much more complex in nature. Here you have a pretty simple file structure with the different shots, and inside of these shots, the different exported layers. These folders contain the standard EbSynth file structure as required to run the software, a video or source folder, a keyframe or stylization folder, and the different output iterations. You can take a look at their documentation to see how you have to set up your own. We're also looking for a way to automate this process, as it is pretty straightforward. The next step is the paint over, or using whatever technique you want to size your shot. I selected a single frame for each shot, preferably one that shows as much information and surface as possible, and sent it over to a graphic designer who created a wash painting using the original image from Unreal. As long as you respect the outline of the original layer, EbSynth's tracking should be pretty consistent, though fast movement and occlusions will mess everything up, which is why it's better to work with transparent layers which can isolate the background from the foreground, for example. Most examples and demos who use EbSynth were created through digital means, which is also a good workflow if you want to create something quickly and be able to make changes on the fly, in Photoshop for example. Here are some samples of earlier tests that we made using different techniques. The next step was to process everything with EbSynth. The key here is trial and error. You may want to play around with different parameters using a lower resolution to see what works best with your original frames and your stylized keyframe. I'll include a list of the different parameters that you can play with in the article if you want to check those out. You can also process multiple layers at the same time, but beware! EbSynth is still in beta and it's quite the gourmand in terms of CPU or GPU resources. If it ever runs out of memory, it will not necessarily crash, but simply output blank frames. You might not realize that your scene has crashed until you look at the final result. So don't be greedy and try to keep an eye on the process when EbSynth is working with a heavy load. Sometimes the results will be far from satisfactory. In that case, you might want to tweak a few parameters, but do keep a log of these changes if you want to be able to understand what works and what doesn't. Here are a few tips to ensure that everything works properly. First, check your original scene. Some anti-aliasing effects, or lack thereof, can create artifacts such as sliding edges. EbSynth is pretty accurate, and so if your original scene has artifacts going on, it will replicate those as well. Second, check if your textures have enough information. EbSynth does not like uniform surfaces, and this is where using Unreal can be handy. You may want to swap out your material for something more gritty, or even for a grid light texture that will help the software understand what it should be tracking. You can play around with lighting as well to get more detail out of dark areas, or push normal maps to get more out of your surfaces. Sometimes with EbSynth, the uglier the better. Third, see if the keyframe is too different from the original image. You're mostly looking for a different outline, for example, which might cause spills. Don't hesitate to correct the keyframe if it doesn't work out. There are many other tips and tweaks that I could share, but I'm afraid that this video is already too long. Let me know in the comments if you need more information or if you're having trouble understanding something, and I will see what I can do. I'm pretty excited about this workflow. It's creative, it's fun, it's cheap, it's efficient, and it's made possible by real-time tools, as we can't really afford to wait out a 3D render only to process it a second time to see the final look. As it relies a lot on trial and error, you also need to be able to make quick adjustments. As for me, our next few shorts will explore other aspects like facial animation, more complex scenes, and so on, to try and flesh out a complete workflow using EbSynth for animation. My own goal is to have something that can allow me to create something of quality as quickly as possible and perhaps push this type of workflow as a way to create pitch fizz or definitive content using the strength of the Unreal ecosystem and EbSynth to create things that are unique and cost-effective from a production standpoint. In fact, OZYMANDIAS is a demo for a miniseries we're currently working on called Parnassos, which will use this new type of pipeline to talk about poetry and art history. Thanks for following along with me. Let me know your thoughts, follow us, and subscribe to our newsletter if you want to keep in touch. See you soon, and until next time.